everybody ready?
Ready!
Is everybody ready?
Ready!
Receiver Dave Johnson, wondered if I might speak with him.
I don't see any problem, man.
Thank you.
Okay.
I'm Ted Sankovich of the University of Texas. I've been keeping a close eye on you, Dave, and you're damn good. I wonder if I could sit down with you and your family and talk over some possibilities.
Well, I ain't got no family. We can still talk.
Well, how about Sunday after your homecoming game?
Cool.
Beautiful. I'll see you at 4 o'clock. Good day.
How've you been?
Cool.
Who's that guy you were talking to?
Brother.
Dave, come on. So how was your day today?
Cool.
I was wondering if maybe we could get together Saturday night and maybe go to the show after the game or something.
Cool.
8 o'clock sound good?
Cool.
You know, it must be cool out here, because that's all you've been saying for the past 5 minutes.
What can I say?
You're tired. I'll let you go home and get some rest. I'll see you tomorrow.
Thank you.
seat when the bell rings, do you, Robert? You students must learn how to calculate time faster.
Jump back.
And where do you think you're coming from this late?
I think I was coming from the hall, Mr. Sinkus.
Well, I think you better put it away.
What, the hallway?
The shake, Dave, the shake. Lunch was 2 hours ago.
I'm special. I can lunch whenever I feel like it.
Not when you can't do a simple algebra problem. You see, Dave, there's more to school than just football. There's your schoolwork. And that, my boy, you're not too hot at.
What do you mean I'm not so hot in my work?
Why don't you go up to the board and do problem number one and show the class how really smart you are?
I ain't got to prove myself to nobody. Everybody know I'm the best.
Then do the problem.
No.
You see, class, he isn't as spectacular as he looks. He's just another dumb football player like all the rest.
I ain't dumb.
He's not gonna get anywhere in college. He'll get hit in the wrong place at the right time, and bam, he'll be worthless.
I ain't dumb.
Dave, you're not going anywhere
in life. I ain't dumb.
You think you're so good, but you're nothing but a piece of trash blowing in the wind.
Go ahead.
Hey, what you doing out of class?
I don't know.
In here, take that silly hat and glasses off.
It looks like our football star is having a few discipline problems. A lot of colleges are interested in you. Michigan State, Notre Dame, Purdue, USC. But by the looks of your grades, you might not even graduate from high school. And if you don't graduate, you don't go to college. And if you don't go to college, you don't play football, no matter how good you are. And so I would advise that you shape up fast, or you might even end up being the chief water boy next year.
Yeah.
have a cell over there? I think I like it.
You crazy. You ain't good enough to get her.
I think I can get her.
Right.
Watch this. Hello?
You ain't good enough to get her. You couldn't get a fly if you tried, chump.
I wonder why Dave was so grumpy yesterday.
I don't know. Maybe he had a tough day at practice.
Boy, I sure do like him. I'm supposed to go out with him Saturday night after the game.
I can't wait. I hope you have fun.
And I'm also going to see if he'll ask me to the homecoming dance next week.
Are you ready for homecoming, Queen?
No. Too many politics. Topic sentence is at the beginning of a paragraph and tells what the paragraph is about.
That's correct. Very good, Lisa. Now, class, on page 68 in your book, you will find a group of topic sentences and a group of paragraphs. I want you to match the correct topic sentence with the corresponding paragraph. Number one, Chiquita.
B.
Wrong. Lisa?
D.
Very good. That's correct. Number two, Akira.
D.
No. Lisa?
C.
Correct. Number three, Alton. Alton. Alton.
The following verbs are examples of
wrong. Wrong page, wrong problem, wrong person. Lisa?
D.
Wrong also.
Eddie, come up to the board and do problem number two.
For me, now?
Right now, Eddie.
Right now? What now?
Now, Eddie.
What do you mean you know before you know you have to need it?
Yes, you do.
Play football. It's too dangerous. People hitting you all the time. Boy, I couldn't let them hit me.
What do you mean? They already do. late.
Oh, yeah?
Dave is supposed to pick me up at 8.
Hey, baby, anybody sitting next to your gorgeous self? Oh, yeah, you really smell good today. What's your name?
Lisa.
And I seriously want to get with you tonight at 8. How about that? Tell me something.
I have a date.
With who? Who could be better than Robert T. Coleman III, baby? Tell me. Tell me. Let me know something.
Dave Johnson.
Hey, baby. You in the way. Hey, hold it. I want to get with you tonight. You go with Dave Johnson?
Hello? She isn't here right now. Who's calling? I'll tell her that you called.
I know my mother buys my
Bye.
Okay? I'm in love with the girl that means very much to me.
Boy, I didn't know there was this many girls that go in.
You do. Nerd.
Oh, here comes Black Harry. Watch this. Hello.
See what I mean?
Mrs. Anderson, may I go get a drink of water, please?
Yes, but come right back.
So, how was your weekend? Why should it be of any concern to you? Well, I heard it through that good old grapevine that you were still Saturday night by Mr. Perfect. Boy, I tell you, some girls got it, some don't. You see, maybe if you had a better grasp on him, he would have been with you instead of with me on Saturday night.
Well, you were just getting used anyway.
How would you know? Oh, then again, you would know because that's the only thing that ever happens to you.
You don't know anything about me, so just keep out of my way.
What are you scared of? A little competition?
You're no competition to me. You don't even have half the quality.
You think you're so sweet. Dave don't want no lame brains, so gonna spend half her time in the library.
And Dave definitely doesn't want anybody who's gonna major in cheerleading for the rest of her life. You see, I have something to offer Dave. All you have to offer him is a trip to bed. That's the only thing he could ever want from you.
No, honey. Last night, I proved to myself to Dave that I am much more of a woman than you could ever be. He told me that if he needed a woman, you wouldn't be close to the list. So face it, Lisa, you're only worth a Canadian penny, which doesn't mean anything to you.
On a Sunday, sunny afternoon at the 1986 homecoming game between De La Salle and DuPois. You know, Lyle, it's been an exciting game so far. We got DuPois trailing by 2 touchdowns. Seems to be, we're going to have a battle in the hands. It's not going to be a pushover. Seems like DuPois got their fans turning out for them. What do you think about that?
Well, you know, surprisingly enough, David Johnson hasn't made any touchdowns thus far. The great number 11 has only gained 33 yards for the first half.
I noticed that.
Hey, a sorry accomplishment for a player of his caliber. What do you think?
You know, Coach Rowland, he's not too pleased with him. And I think all the fans that turned out for him that traveled all the way from Detroit and surrounding area, they're not too pleased with him at all. I really hope he gets his act together during the second half. He's still got time to go.
But De La Salle really has shown that they got their stuff together by containing David Johnson and DP's offense. I mean, it's just been amazing.
Yes, you see that barricade is very effective. And if it can stop Dave Johnson, we see it can stop everybody. We see the fans have really turned out droves. So I really hope that they do a lot better during the second half. And here they come back out on the field during the second half.
You know, this is a really elaborate homecoming for in high school. I mean, when I was in high school, we had our little homecoming in our backyard.
Now, I know. They're using Pontiac Silverdome now with the professionals, all
right. That's right. And there's Coach Rowland's assistant, Coach Ron Thompson. There's the line of St. Martin DePorts Eagles.
Yeah, I hope DePorts, they can play like professionals since they're in this atmosphere during the second half. De La Salle got the ball. It's looking good.
There's a flag down on the play.
Was it a fumble? It was a fumble. Let's see if they can do better in the second half. Then it didn't get any yards from that one.
Yeah. The Pours have the ball now on the 30. And there's number 30. He's going now. Oh, look at that block by number 22.
Looking good. He's got 15, 20 yards on
man,
that
he
one.
He knocked that man down, Jim.
Yeah.
Did you see that?
Very good block. Very good block. That's good defense. Really good defense.
Yeah. Another flag down on the play. Okay. 10-yard drop back.
It wasn't any good. It wasn't any good. He went out of bounds.
Yeah. Back at the 30. And you hear the crowd is really rooting for the Pours.
Yeah,
they're trying to get a rally
up. This might help. This might help. They need that support. The Pours got the ball.
Pitch back, number 33. He's going down to 30 and down at the 31-yard line. That was a nice play.
Yes, it
think,
was.
Jim?
It sure was. I think they're going to come back.
Yeah, they're trying
really
hard.
Do.
Yeah,
I think
hard.
The coaches took him back in the locker room and gave him a pep talk.
And there's number 11, Dave Johnson.
Oh,
down.
He's hit good. Okay.
Oh, boy. That was only 3 yards, you know.
He didn't get too many yards.
No, he could do better now.
I don't think
fans.
The fans like that.
No, they don't. Not at
they
all.
They got to do better. They got to.
And the Pours is kicking off to De La Salle.
Will they take it? They will take it. De La Salle is going.
That's Jefferson. He's going to the 5, to the 10. He's down
looking
at the 20.
Good. He got some yards. He got some yards.
I tell you, the Pours is going to have a hard time.
They're going to have to come back strong. They're going to have to.
They got to.
Touchdown. Only one touchdown. Can they do it? Player set. I tell you, this is really generating some suspense. If it was my guess, they'd throw it to Dave Johnson.
Help.
Calm down. Just calm down.
Why the hell can I move my legs?
Mr. Johnson.
What?
Mr. Johnson. There's something I must tell you. I looked at your lab reports, the x-rays. You may never walk again. When you were hit, it crushed your spinal nerve. It affected your lower legs.
I can't play football again?
You may be able to walk again. You won't be in sports again.
I have to play football. I got scholarships, I got awards, I have fans, I gotta play.
I'm sorry.
You're sorry, do you know what this is gonna do to me?
Just try to relax.
I have to play.
Relax, try to relax. Get some rest. Your nurse will be back soon.
Misses you. The team really misses you. They lost yesterday.
Leave me alone.
I know you're upset about...
Leave me alone. I don't need your sympathies. I don't need your apologies. I don't need anything from you. Get out. Get out.
Glad to see you're back. Sorry to hear about what happened. On page 83, class, there are some math refresher problems that will help you brush up on your skills. Here, 3.5 plus 4 3/4 equals what, Dave? What's the answer, Dave?
5 4/8
Okay, class. Let's let him have another chance. Let's try another one, Dave. Number 5. 486 divided into 5,890.
Eight.
Come here, David. Come here. Well, well, well. You're in a wheelchair.
and you still find a way to get out of class. Every time I see you, you're in trouble. I think it's time for you to go down and see Mrs. Jackson. Maybe she can straighten you out.
David, all I have to say is this. I know it's been hard for you since the accident. It's time you start getting it together. So far, you don't have enough credits to graduate, which means come June 12th, you'll still be with us. It would be a miracle for you to make up all the credits you've lost. Young man, you have a lot of work ahead of you, and I don't mean on the playing field.
Please, he needs to breathe.
All the way back. All the way back.
Minutes, third quarter now.
34!
Harmon again to the outside. He's got some blockers. Stop short of the goal line. Stephon Adams, that's a good play.
It is, because he had Guy McIntyre, number 62, coming out there leading, and that looked like it was going to be a big play. Watch McIntyre, 62. He's out in front there. Right now, it looks like they have something going. He plays off him, comes from the inside, makes the tackle, gets off the block, and gets two of them on it. That really wasn't McIntyre's fault. He got a pretty good block.
Yeah,
it was the force or support from the inside.
Adams. Third and goal just inside the two.
I don't think Bill Walsh would like to see Tom Rapp.
You're damn good.
I'm special. I can love to know Ralph B. You.
You may never walk again.
You'll get him in the wrong place at the right time, and bam.
You may never walk again.
You might not even graduate from high school.
What's the matter with this?
What's the answer, Bill?
You have a lot of work ahead.
Yeah. You know,
I wish girls could be in our money. It would be so much easier.
Look, the next time you see the car in the hall, just walk up to him and say something like, "Hi, I've been seeing you around and I've been dying to speak to you." And then see what happens. Cool.
I known you to be depressed.
Just let me be. You weren't here when I needed you. And now you come popping just because you got an A. See, you don't understand. You had your fame. You had your days of being a superstar. What did I get? Nothing but being the lowlife of the school. And so-called women. Lame, sissy, coward. That's what I got. Total rejection. You want to know what's wrong with me? I was cut from the swim team. My only chance to prove to the school that I was really human. My chance to be that human. Well, there's nothing like getting a school to cheer for you. That's what I wanted, to be just like you.
You didn't want this. I failed. Everybody put their trust in me, and look what I gave
them. But you had your family worried.
It's better not to have your family have it stripped away from you. I paid for my mistakes, and I paid for them greatly.
Look at you. You got the best girl in the world behind you, and I can't even get a simple girlfriend. Remember, you said so yourself. I can't even get a fly.
Eddie, make me eat my words.
I will. I just asked my friend.
So what grade are you?
11.
Me too.
I'll be glad when you graduate.
You ain't lying. It seems like we've been here forever.
You going to the graduation Sunday?
Yeah, are you?
Now I am.
Skips a beat, and I get so excited that I can't stand on my feet. When we're together, it's easy to see that you're the special one made just for me. Look, Kyra, like a dream come true, here I am, spending my life. Peaches and cream, we're the perfect combination, because we live each day in a total celebration. Cairo, like a dream come true, here I am, right here next to you. Look, Cairo, by looking into your eyes, I can tell. Stay alive.
afternoon, everyone. I would like to welcome you to this year's commencement ceremony. It gives me great pleasure to be here in the company of so many fine graduates who had the determination and the perseverance to make it through a very tough time in their lives. I'd like to open this ceremony with a very special presentation to a special young man. He has shown courage beyond all expectations. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. David Johnson. After my accident, I gave up hope. I had no confidence in myself. I was down considering suicide, but with the help of God, I slowly regained my confidence in myself. I must say, never neglect your education. It is essential for survival in the world. For those freshmen, sophomores, and juniors out there that never play sports and dream of becoming a professional without an education, remember, school comes first. I'm a prime example. I used to dream of becoming a pro football player, like my father. And by doing so, I neglected my education. I almost lost both. But with determination and help from good friends, I conquered my problem. Lisa, wherever you are, thank you for having faith in me when I had no faith in myself. You stuck with me during the times I need you most. Eddie. You're the best friend a person could ever have. You show me how a friend is really supposed to be. And I will truly say, you'll never be replaced. Thanks to my counselors, I've decided to become a special education teacher to teach better coping skills to handicapped children. I would just like to end with this note. For those who condemn certain people for their actions and say they will never become anything, remember, all they need is one more chance.